Now to a story you saw first on 5, and 2,000 jobs saved tonight. Cincinnati's main post office will not be shutting down after all. And we found out why it was saved and what it means for you. News host Laura Borchers broke the story and joins us along Dalton Street tonight. Hi, Laura.
Mail will still arrive every day right on time. As we speak right now, employees here at the post office are just inside those doors getting an announcement that their jobs are safe.
Count on your mail being delivered with a bigger smile and maybe even a celebratory honk for a while. They're happy to no longer be living on the bubble while the federal government tries to come up with a plan to fix a $3 billion shortfall in the postal budget. Closing this Cincinnati postal facilities is no longer an option.
Management has just informed us that they have decided to end the AMP study for Cincinnati and that we'll be staying open here. So that's a big news for, 2,000 families in the area.
He calls it a victory of many.
The man upstairs.
Michael.
And my membership.
Michael Funk's fellow postal employees praised his efforts that began with overcoming a fear of cameras. Now hundreds of families breathe again.
We've been looking at transplanting not just families, but our whole career, our whole, existence.
Walt Luthy's lived in this area for all of his 41 years. He wasn't ready to uproot.
Wife and then two children.
Many workers' strolls to the post box now include a spring in their step, and the city no longer has to worry about the ripple effect that the loss of thousands of jobs would have created.
The economic impact of 2,000 jobs at the salaries that are paid here would have been devastating to our economy.
If my members see this ahead of their meeting, congratulations. Celebrate with your family. It's a good day to be in Cincinnati.
The next meeting to employees will be here at the building at 11:30. And remember, there will be more announcements tomorrow morning, so not everyone has heard the news just yet. And there are also still many cities on the list. Dayton is one of those. Reporting live, I'm Laura Borchers, News 5.